Hello everyone, this is the part 2 on the topic subnetting. So we taken an example that is 200.1.2.0 that is given to a particular organization, and the organization divided that 256 different addresses in that class C network into 4 parts, each having say 64 combination. So and the address are ranging like 200.1.2.0 to 63 in subnet 1, and 64 to 127 in subnet 2, 128 to 191 in subnet 3, and 192 to 255 in subnet 4. Now, I am writing here the binary representation of the least significant 8 bits, that is the last octet. So, this 0 can be represented like this, 1, right, 63, like that. Because if you are looking at the network ID, that is the 21 bits, they remain same for all the addresses, and what varying is this least significant octet. So I am looking in detail the binary. Now if you observe here, for any addresses that is within this subnet 1, that is from here to here, you can see that all of them are starting with the 00, right? 00 and the last one also. Similarly, if you look at any IP address in subnet 2, if you look at the host ID part, it is starting with the 01. Similarly here also and here also. And for the third subnet, all the IP addresses are host ID part of the IP address starting with the 10, and for the last one it is 11. So what we can conclude is, initially we have a class C IP address with the network ID 21 bits and host ID 8 bits. Now why this 8 bits are given for identifying a host? Because in a typical class C network we have 256 different machine. Now 256 is 2^8, that is to identify a particular machine out of 256 we need 8 bits, right? But when it is divided into different subnets, within a subnet we have only 64 machines. To make a combination to make 64 different combination, we need only 6 bits, right? That means this 8 bits is not needed now. So what is happening here is, initially we have a host ID that is 8 bit, but now within a subnet we need only 6 bits as the host ID. Why it is 6 bits? Using this 6 bits you can have a 2^6, that is 64 combination. Now within a subnet we have a 64 different machines possible per subnet. Okay, and what happened to the remaining 2 bits? That will be identifying a particular subnet. For example, if those 2 bits are 00, it represents subnet 1. If those bits are 01, it is representing subnet 2. 10 is given for subnet 3 and 11 is given for subnet 4, or normal binary. That is, these 2 bits, if you are observing these 2 bits, it's like 00, 01, 10, 11, 004, identifying subnet 1, and this is for subnet 2, and this is for subnet 3, and this is for subnet 4. So like that you can identify different subnets. So now the address 32 bits in binary has to be viewed like this. There is no change for this 24 bits including this 110 fixed, and the network ID there is no change, and the least significant 8 bits will be splitted now into 6 bits for identifying the host and 2 bits for the subnet. Now remember, as you divided the entire network into 4 subnets, what is 4? 2^2. You need 2 bits for identifying a particular subnet. Now suppose the total network is divided into say 8 different subnets. So 8 is 2^3. 3 bits will be identifying a particular subnet. Okay, that is the concept. Accordingly, the host number of host within a subnet will vary. Okay. Now the question is, suppose an IP packet is coming with IP address from the external router. This is coming to the internal router. Say the IP address is 200.1.2.130. Okay. Now you know what is the binary of 130. This part is fixed anyway for all these addresses. Now what is the binary of 130? Here we saw this 129 is 1 followed by this one is 0 and 1. So 130 is the next one. That is 130 in binary will be 10000 10, right? That is 2 raised to 0, 2 raised to 1. 2 plus 128 will be 130. So this is how you can represent this 130 in binary. Now, we know that this particular IP address belongs to subnet 3, because subnet 3 is having addresses from 128 to 191. As 130 is within this range, it is definitely for subnet 3. Now, you have to come up with an automatic process by which, given this this kind of an IP address, one should be able to identify this subnet 3 correctly. Now, we know that within every subnet, just like a network, the very first IP address is given to identifying the whole subnet, just like a network ID. We know that our original network is having a network ID of 200.1.2.0. So, this is a network ID of this whole 256 combination. Now, that 256 combination is divided into 4 subnets. Now, each subnet is identified by a subnet ID. Okay, subnet ID, SID, that is subnet ID. Now, for this subnet 1, this very first address is acting as a subnet ID, just like the network ID. Okay, now we have network ID as well as subnet ID. Within a network, we have 4 subnets. Each subnet is identified by a subnet ID. If you are looking at the binary, these 2 bits are enough for identifying each subnet. But as a whole, if you are taking as an IP address, this particular IP address as a whole is dedicated for identifying subnet 1. Similarly, for subnet 2, the very first address, that is, this is acting as a subnet ID. And for this one, this is a subnet ID. And for the last subnet, this is a subnet ID. Now, just like we discussed in our normal IP address, within this whole combination, if there is no subnetting at all, this first address is acting as a subnet network ID, and the last address is acting as the network directed broadcast ID, right? This is the network directed broadcast ID. Similarly, now instead of network, we have a subnetwork, right? So, we are interested to broadcast within a subnet. Sometimes you want to broadcast an information to every machine within a subnet. So, we need something called a subnet directed broadcast ID. Subnet directed broadcast ID. Let me denote it like subnet directed broadcast ID or broadcast address. So, we discussed this limited broadcasting and directed broadcasting in our previous video. So, just like a network directed broadcast address, here we have a subnet directed broadcast address that is specific to a given subnet. For example, in for subnet 1, this last address is acting as the subnet directed broadcast address, and the very first address is acting as the subnet ID. Okay. So, for subnet 2, this is a subnet ID, and the last address, and that is this one, will be subnet directed broadcast address. Similarly, for this one, this will be the subnet directed broadcast address. And for the last subnet, this address will be the subnet directed broadcast address. And the same address is acting as the network directed broadcast address also, if there is no subnetting at all. Okay. So, that is the idea. Now, we saw that within each subnet, we have a 64, 64, 64, 64 combination. Now, out of this 64 combination, the very first address is identifying the subnet, and the last address is identifying the is used for broadcasting within the subnet. Okay, that is applicable for all the subnets. So, what is happening is, even though we have a 64 different combination within a subnet, two of them have a special purpose. So totally we have a 64 addresses. Out of them, two are having special meaning, that is special address, which are there. One is identifying the subnet, that is subnet ID, and another one is the subnet directed broadcast address. And remaining what we have is 62 IP address, valid IP address, within a subnet. That you have to remember, we are not getting 64 combination. Actually, 64 combinations are possible, but two addresses are having special meaning. So, for a given machine, 62 combinations are possible. In our example, we taken an exam where the organization is divided into four different branches, and each branch is having 60 machine, right? So this 62 is enough. Two addresses will be excess in our example, but you have to take care of these two, because 64 combination is actually not possible. Only 62 valid IP addresses are possible within a subnet. Accordingly, you have to perform your subnetting. So that about the special addresses within a subnet. Now our question is, if someone is giving you an address, say 200.1.2.30, whose binary is this one, how you will identify that this is exactly part of subnet 3? Okay, and that is done by a process called subnet mask. That is done with the help of a parameter called subnet mask. Then we will see how it is to be done. So what we need is an automatic process of doing it. Okay.